Alrighty, all. I think we're about finished now, ain't we?
Just about, yes. Sweetie Belle, did you finish your field research?
I did, Scootaloo, and what I found proved to be very interesting.
Awesome. Then I guess we can call it quits with our investigation. And not a minute too soon, I mean, that was quite an adventure, eh?
You can say that again. After facing countless troubles, a confrontation with the Black Organization, and a brief legal dispute with Gosho Aoyama over the fair use of the name Detective Boys, finally the cutie mark detective girls are able to solve this case. To reveal what really happened to poor old Mr. Cake.
Excuse me, but is that what you called us all here today?
Yeah. We wanted to make sure everyone witnesses our great breakthrough. Especially the cutie marks we're gonna get afterwards.
Well, sorry if I sound a little harsh now, but what kind of breakthrough are you even talking about? The case is already closed, you girls. Me and my team came to the conclusion that my first assumption as to what had happened was correct. It was nothing but a tragic accident that cost Mr. Cake his life. The blood traces at the body's location were undoubtable proof.
You'd think so, officer. But ain't it weird that that cleaver Mr. Cake had in spec still had visible blood stains even though the body was in the water? According to your theory, he went there himself, so he must still live then. And that suggests the blood couldn't have dried already.
Are you sure you're not mixing something up there? Because according to forensics, there was only very little blood still on that cleaver. Most of it was, like you said, washed off in the water.
That's odd. Because I distinctly remember how that cleaver looked. It was covered in blood, and the stains were almost black. I don't think it was ultra fresh, that blood. Which makes you wonder, how come forensics did only find traces of it? Where did it go?
How the fuck should I know? Maybe you're just remembering wrong. Which is completely fair, I mean, the sight of a corpse at that young age can be a little much.
If it were only memories we're talking about, yes. But I also took a photo of Mr. Cake while AB and Scoots were getting the police. See here? You can easily spot the dark stains on this photo.
Hey, what the hell? You can't just take a photo of a crime scene. That's illegal. Give me that.
Hold on, Officer Deputy. Doesn't that photo shed a new light on this case? Why are you so against it?
You ain't trying to hide anything, are you?
Is it no? Fine, go on then.
With pleasure. Now, we believe that the crime actually took place somewhere entirely different. And Mr. Cape was brought to that lake only after he was already dead. The culprit dropped him off here and hastily made it look like it could have been an accident.
So you're saying it was a planned crime? A real murder?
Well, actually it wasn't no first degree or even second.
Yes, it was more like an effective action, we think. We do believe it was an accident, but it wasn't Mr. Cake who put that cleaver in his back. The culprit likely got into a fight with Mr. Cake while holding that cleaver, and at some point, they probably swung it at him, maybe not even with the intention to hit him. But hit him, it did.
And do you also have an idea who this culprit is, Maddles?
We do. That's why we invited her here, to confront her about it. We believe the one who did this is... you, Mrs. Cake.
What? How absurd. Shame on you, you little brats. How dare you accuse me like that? I'm the one who lost her husband. And you wanna say I killed him? Based on what assumption?
Well, on that marital quarrel y'all were having.
What kind of quarrel? Everything was fine between Carrot and me.
The one about your children, to be precise.
My, what did you say?
Your kids, Mrs. Cake. Pound and Pumpkin. We suppose Mr. Cake found out that they weren't actually his.
What? Holy shit! My goodness, I never heard anything so outrageous in my entire life. The brass of you to suspect something so unheard of. Of course Pound and Pumpkin are his children. How are you gonna prove me wrong, huh?
Simple. Them freckles, Mrs. Cake. Your husband always had pretty noticeable freckles in his face, and your babies don't got a single one of them.
Yeah, and since freckles are hereditary, shouldn't you at least be able to see a little of it? But both your babies' faces are clean and freckle-free.
Now I've had enough of these stupid accusations, all based on nothing but half-knowledge. Freckles have no guarantee to be inherited by the kids, you idiot girls!
If it were only one kid we're talking about, that argument would be valid. But two children, where the chances are twice as high? And still, not a single freckle.
All right, fine. Let's pretend it was like that. Still, where would that be a motive for me? If Carrot really found out something like that, then we would have just divorced. There would be no need to go and kill him over that.
Stop trying to play it all cool, Miss Cake. We know you ain't feeling like that. You might want to act all cold and non-caring, but everybody knows you love your kids. And a divorce, you didn't want to do that to them. You wanted the family to remain whole, and you were begging your husband to stay after he found out. But he wanted to leave you after getting behind your unfaithfulness. You didn't know what to do. And in your panic, you saw that cleaver lying around and you grabbed it. You likely only wanted to threaten him a little at first, but in the heat of the moment, he probably got even more angry when he saw that thing in your hands. He started provoking you, didn't he? Calling you all kinds of nasty things. Until you finally couldn't hold yourself back anymore.
That's enough, you little shit! Don't you see she's a grieving wife? How dare you talk to her like that? Do you even have the slightest proof of all you just claimed? Because false accusations are a crime as well. How do you even want to know Mr. Cake found it out?
Deputy, there was nothing to be found out.
Right. Those scars are getting me all worked up.
Actually, we do. A couple weeks back, Sugarcube Cafe was closed temporarily. Say, Mrs. Cake, the roles in your household were more traditionally oriented, weren't they? Your husband was mainly focused on your cafe while you were taking care of the children.
Yes? So what? Is it forbidden nowadays for a mother to want to care for her babies?
Some feminists would say that, yeah.
Shush up, Boom. This is a serious sketch. No dumb jokes.
Sorry.
Anyhow, the cafe was mainly run by Mr. Cake, yes? And that time it was closed. What was going on there? The note on the door said something about family matters, but what exactly was it?
I don't know. I think I had a case of the flu and was forced to stay in bed. I had him take over my duties that day.
Exactly. And that precisely was the moment he found out them kids weren't his. Usually because of his work, Mr. Cake only ever got to see his kids late in the evening and when he was all tired. But then he was able to take a real close look at them. And that's when he noticed that they didn't really look like him at all.
And that's all you're building this theory on? All you just said is nothing but just another theory. I was asking for proof. Do I need to define the word for you?
No, because we actually do have some. Scootily went to Neverloose Hub Hospital recently to check something out, and what she came back with was quite something. Right, Scoots? Yeah. I was lucky to run into Dr. Wheatley, and because it was him I was talking to, I managed to obtain knowledge any clear-thinking member of hospital staff would have never told me.
Like what, for example?
Like that one day Mr. Cake showed up in the clinic with some hair samples of his kids and wanted to take a paternity test.
He what?
Yes. And wouldn't you know it, that test happened to be negative. I'm sure Dr. Wheatley will gladly repeat what he told me to the police. He literally won't think much of it.
It's true. He found it out.
Cup, you don't need to say anything.
But I do. I didn't want any of this. You have to believe me. I didn't mean to.
What happened, Mrs. Cake? Please, come clean with us.
I knew the moment he walked into the room that something was up. His face, his whole demeanor. But never would I have thought he... It was just a small slip-up. I loved my husband, I really did. But when he found out I cheated on him, it was terrifying. He was yelling and screaming, threatening me like I never heard before. He threatened to throw me out and keep the kids. And even if I would have gotten custody of them, the store and apartment, we would have been without a home. And they're still just babies. I didn't mean to.
Enough! Can't you see this woman is a nervous wreck? No wonder after what she's lost. And even though they were fighting, nobody just kills a man like that. Not because of this. I, as a cop, know these things.
Oh, well, shouldn't you as a cop know that crimes of passion are amongst the most frequent motives?
Who's got the statistics here, you or me? Besides, you might have bullied Mrs. Cake into admitting her adultery, but I will not allow you to force her into incriminating herself for a crime she didn't commit. I was the one leading the investigations, and there were no signs of any involvement on her part. No DNA, no fingerprints, nothing. She couldn't possibly have done it.
Say, you're being really vehement about defending her, Officer Deputy. Why is that exactly? Shouldn't you as a police officer try to remain neutral? And be interested to view the case from this perspective, too?
What are you trying to say, Missy?
A Okay, to put it bluntly, officer, what exactly kind of relation you two got, anyhow?
What, me and Mrs. Cake? Well, I would say pretty distant. We do know each other by face, but that's about it.
That's so. What you call her by her first name, then?
What?
A few minutes ago. Don't think I ain't noticed that.
So I know her first name, so what? I was trying to be sensitive with her because of her emotional state.
Well, just saying, for you only knowing her by face, you are pretty strictly against her having anything to do with this case.
Just because I was leading the investigations. I know what I saw. I know what forensics told me. I even signed the file myself. I could even go and get it if you insist on that. Then you can read for yourself that all of this theorizing here is getting us nowhere.
One second, Officer Deputy. I would like to try something, if you don't mind.
And what is it? What are you up to?
Nothing bad, Officer. Don't worry. I just want to touch your arm for a moment.
Okay. What for?
For this. Ah. Oh my God. So it is true.
Wait, what's true?
The theory. The Cutie Crusaders were right about everything. Mrs. K killed her husband by accident.
What? No, she did not. What the fuck are you talking about?
I saw it in your mind, Deputy. Your memories. After Mrs. Cake had killed her husband, she came to Officer Deputy, not knowing what to do, begging him to help her. And he told her everything was gonna be fine. He would take care of it. He himself left the body by the lake in the city park. And during investigations, he made every piece of evidence that would point towards Mrs. Cake vanish.
What? You're for real now? Damn it, Robotus, I was just being sarcastic when I said he's got something to do with it.
No, wait, hold on. That part is brand new to us. Why would he help cover up a murder?
Because, Officer Deputy, he was Mrs. Cake's lover. And he's the real father of Pound and Pumpkin.
That's ridiculous. Why do you people even believe this girl? I mean, all she did was touch my arm, and then she just went and made up all of that stuff.
Now hold on a minute there, Deputy. Sunset might be no less a bitch than any of us, but we do know that she wouldn't lie about something like that.
Obviously she would. I mean, why would she suddenly know all of this?
Oh right, didn't I mention? I have this bullshit mind-reading power I can use to look inside people. Really useful from time to time. So yeah, no point in denying it anymore. I saw it before my own mind's eye.
All right. It's true. Cup did come to me and asked me to help her. I was glad to do this for her. After the kids were born, she almost completely broke off any contact. I respected that. I only ever wanted her to be happy. But when she came to me that day, soaking wet from the rain, tears in her eyes, shaking like a leaf, I knew what I had to do. So I took her car and drove it to the city park. I put the body in the water, made sure there were footprints visible, and that he would be found shortly. Then I took on this case myself to control investigations. I know I swore an oath on my badge, but I couldn't allow Cup to be thrown in jail. Not for her kids' sake. They already lost one parent. I couldn't rob them of the other one, too. But one thing about your assumptions is wrong. It was indeed not Cup who killed her husband.
Cup? What? What does that mean?
After you left, I went to the trunk of your car and opened it to have a look at what I would be dealing with. And when I looked into Carrot's eyes, they were looking back at me. I panicked in that moment. I didn't know what to do. If he'd survived, surely he would have sued his wife for attempted murder. And then her children, our children, would have lost their mother. I couldn't let that happen. So I finished the job. I put him in the water and left him there. I did it for you, Cup. For our kids, our family, for us.
Us? No, Deputy. You don't need to lie anymore. It's all right. I did it. And I really did it for us. For me, my children, my husband.
I was in over my head in that moment and my mind blanked. Far too late, I realized the mistake I had made all those years ago. I'm sorry, Deputy, but it was a mistake. I should have talked with Carrot about our problems, about his work taking everything out of him. How his kids never really got to see him. How he was missing their lives. But I was too proud. I'm sorry. I love you, Deputy. But I love my family more.
Cub. Please.
All of this was only my fault. If I had just remained faithful to Carrot, then none of this would have happened. And now, because I was trying to prevent my family from falling apart, I have achieved exactly that. My poor babies. They're the real victims here. Both of their parents they lost because of me. All I ask of you is one thing, girls. Find them a good family. Let them live a happy life. Cuties.
Well, that was... Well, I ain't gonna lie, that was quite impressive, sis. Y'all girls actually solved the real murder case. Not bad for a bunch of kids.
But one thing I'm still wondering, how did you get behind the fact that the Cake twins weren't actually Kara's offspring? Surely you needed more to go by than just them looking different.
Actually, yeah. I mean, the base suspicion I had from the beginning, but I of course would have never went for accusing her without making sure before.
And how did you make sure?
Well, by doing some research. You maybe remember how I had disappeared for a day recently?
All the dinks. You had me real worried, young missus. And where were you there?
I had gone to Equestria to check something out. I sought out the pony version of the Cake family and checked if they would match my suspicion. Given that Equestria and this world are mirrors of each other, it would have made sense. And so it did, in fact. Pounded pumpkin cake are also not Carrot's kids in Equestria.
Really?
Yes. It's even more obvious there because not only were they also lacking the freckles their father had, but they were just entirely different races. Both Carrot and his wife are Earth ponies, but his kids are a unicorn and a Pegasus. Sure, they might have tried explaining doubts away with that bullshit excuse about distant relatives and whatnot, but even in that episode, Mr. Cake wasn't sure he could believe that. So Pony Cub also committed adultery. But unlike our Mr. Cake, his pony version is just a huge pushover, so he basically just cucked himself and accepted it.
Ah, now it makes sense. Honestly, I just thought you went to Equestria to live out your nudist fetish.
Excuse me?
Where ponies don't wear no clothes.
Seriously, Appleboom, real talk. Why do you always, about every little thing, have to try and make something up about a fetish for me? Your Equestria version does that too. What gives, man? Are you maybe projecting something there?
No. Okay, anyway, back to topic. Only time will tell if Mrs. Cake or Officer Deputy would actually face justice in this broken system of a state government. But at least they're both in custody now. That's something, isn't it?
By the way, which version is not actually true, Sunset? Did really Officer Deputy finish the job on Mr. Cake?
No, actually, that was a lie. He must have been trying to steer blame away from his mistress, but Mrs. Cake proved a great sense of honor and stood by her actions.
Well, so I guess he also must have sincerely loved her. And her and his children.
Why didn't you say anything? You knew he was lying.
I don't know, I found his gesture so moving that I just couldn't bring myself to it. The case was solved either way, and I didn't want to ruin that moment by but actually-ing.
Ah, fair enough. Kate and Fats, that was very good work of you, Cutie Mark Crusaders.
Thanks! But Jesse wait and see until I reveal my Cutie Mark. After solving this case professional like we have, I think it's safe to say we found our special talents, eh, girls? Now let me see, what is it?
Hey, what the fuck, Apple Bloom? Put your pants back up! What's wrong with you?
Chillax, sis, I just wanna see my Cutie Mark is all! Come on, where is it? What's it look like?
No.
Ain't no cutie marks on my cheeks, is there?
Nope.
Fucking hell. I was so excited. I mean, if that doesn't get us one, what will?
Nothing. Because humans, like I said well before, cannot get cutie marks.
She's right about that.
Don't you quit us, Alia. I ain't giving up just yet.
Well, anyhow, cutie mark or not, you still did a great job, kids.
Yeah. Keep that up and maybe one day you'll also be part of the main cast. Yeah.
Whatever you say, Twilight.
Whatever you say.